In this lesson, we'll look at three introductory work problems. For a quick review, looking at the notes below, if a variable force f of x moves an object in a positive direction along the x-axis from point A to point B, the work done on the object is equal to the integral from A to B of f of x dx. However, if f of x is constant, the work is equal to the force times the distance. For number one, suppose you lift a stone that has a mass of 5.7 kilograms off the floor onto a shelf that is 3 meters high. How much work have you done? You need to be careful here. The 5.7 kilograms is mass, not force. We need to begin by determining the force. Recall the force F is equal to the mass M times A, the acceleration due to gravity. Which means in this case, the force is equal to the mass of 5.7 times the acceleration due to gravity, which is 9.8 meters per second squared, which gives a force of 55.86. Now we can calculate the work. And because this force doesn't change, we have a constant force, which means you can determine the work by determining the product of the force and the distance. The work W is equal to the force of 55.86 times the distance of 3 meters, which equals 167.58 joules. Looking back at the notes for a moment, in the metric system, the units for work are joules or newton meters. In US customary units, the units of work are foot-pounds. For number two, suppose you lift a laptop that weighs 5.6 pounds off the floor onto a shelf that is 2 feet high. How much work have you done? In this case, the 5.6 pounds is the force, and we also have the distance, which is 2 feet. And because we have a constant force, we know the work W is equal to the force of 5.6 pounds times the distance of 2 feet, which equals 11.2 foot-pounds. And then finally for number three, the force of a particle is described by 5x cubed minus 2 pounds at a point x feet along the x-axis. Find the work done in moving the particle from the origin to x equals 4. Notice here we do have a variable force of 5x cubed minus 2, which means the work W is equal to the integral from x equals 0 at the origin to x equals 4, which indicates the limits of integration are from 0 to 4 of the force function, which is 5x cubed minus 2 dx. Next, we determine the antiderivative. Integrating 5x cubed minus 2, we have 5 times x to the fourth divided by 4, or 5 fourths x to the fourth minus 2x. Now we determine big F of 4 minus big F of 0, which gives us 5 fourths times the fourth power of 4 minus 2 times 4, and then minus when x is 0. Notice both terms are 0. Simplifying, 5 fourths times 4 to the fourth is equal to 320. Minus 2 times 4, which is 8. The work is equal to 312 foot-pounds. I hope you found this helpful.